It's you!
You know?
What's good, everybody? It's your boy, UncleSamsReject here, and welcome back to the channel, boys. And we are right back with some more Howard University Dynasty here on NCAA Basketball 10. After game number one, we are 1-0. We beat a Big East team in Rutgers 48-47. And one thing we're going to do going into the second game, boys, is we're going to up the half length to 15 minutes. 12 is just a little bit too short. If you guys were here back when I had the Ole Miss Dynasty and we had that Dynasty going on, you guys already know we're going to have episodes with more than one game in it. We're going to play full games. We're going to jump into some games here and there. That way we can get through the seasons quickly. But you know what I'm saying? 30-plus games is a lot every single season to try to play one by one by one. So, you know what I mean? We're going to make it fun, interactive, and we're going to have, you know what I'm saying, we're going to be in and out a lot of these seasons as we try to, you know what I'm saying, become that perennial powerhouse. Now, right now, take a look at our target list that we created last episode. You know what I'm saying? We are now number one on Bob Douglas's list. We are number one on John Erickson's list. We are number one on John Fisher's list. We are in the top three for Nathan Glenn. We're number one for Derek Ingram. We're number one for Mario McDowell. And we are number two for Andy Richard. So only 42 points remaining. You know what I'm saying? Four of the, what's that? One, two, three, four, five of our seven prospects that we're going at are in our pipeline. So that's why a lot of them don't cost a lot. But, you know what I'm saying? I want to get these guys pretty quickly. I want to offer them their scholarship so they can sign with us. That way we can just worry about playing, you know what I'm saying, with the guys we have on the team now. So if you guys see here, we are able to offer scholarships to these guys. And like I just said, man, we're not going to play any games. We're going to offer scholarships. You know what I'm saying? We're going to send a phone call with the assistant coach. Where's he from? He's from Minnesota, so we really can't talk about location to him. I mean, I really don't think he's going to care about coming to D.C. Playing time, since we're losing shooting guards, could be higher, but let's just try a coach strategy. Now, John Erickson is a pipeline guy, so, you know what I mean, phone calls for him are much, much cheaper. So we'll give him a head coach phone call. We'll throw some playing time at him, seeing how he's feeling about that, and we'll offer him a scholarship. Fisher, another guy who's in our pipeline. So we'll give him a head coach call as well. Let's see if he likes our coach strategy and we'll offer him his scholarly. Glenn, another DMV guy. We're top three on his list. Hopefully we can jump up with a scholarship offer. We'll go ahead and give him a head coach call as well. I feel like he'll get a lot of playing time if he comes into this team. Only 18 points left here, man. So we're going after Glenn. We're going to go ahead and offer him a scholarly. We'll give him a head coach call as well. Mario McDowell, we're one on his list, but he's not a pipeline guy. You know what I'm saying? With him being from Iowa. So we're just going to offer him a scholarship. And then Andy Richard, last but not least, we're second on his list. Going to offer him a scholarship. He's from PA, so he is in our pipeline. And we'll go ahead and give him a head coach call as well. All right, man. So we're going to recruit him. We've offered scholarships to all seven of our recruits on our target list. And hopefully we can get a big chunk of them. All right, guys. So in this episode, we're going to be going up against the Denver Pioneers. They're one game in just like us. And BB Amit, their small forward, is their leading scorer. He had 27 in that game. Next score after that is going to be Ben Holmes with 11. Then they got Tim Miller with 9, Mathis with 8, Clinton with 7. And that's pretty much the bulk of their scoring right there. You take a look at us after one game. J.P. Parker had 23 points, 15 for Timothy White, 8 for Stephen Harris, and only 2 from Oyen. One thing we want to try to do is get our guy Teddy Bontez, you know what I mean, into the scoring category. He did a great job. He did a great job running the offense, being the floor general. But since he can't shoot, it's hard for me to score and get to the basket with him. But we're going to try to do a little bit better here in this game. All right, guys. So take a look at their starting lineup. They got Henderson, Clinton, Amit, Holmes, Miller. We're sticking with the same one. Harris, Oyen, White, Parker, and Montez. Let's come out here and get this W.
Welcome to
All right, guys, here we go. We are on the road once again in Denver, Colorado, man. So let's even come out here and get this win as we do win the opening tip. I think we got a good idea what we want our offense to be as we go to J.P. Parker off rip, and he goes. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Yeah, he knocks down the three. Use the shot clock. Be smart here. You know what I'm saying? With 15-minute quarters or halves, we got to be smart. Good move with the pump fake. I mean, with the drop step, the hop step. But we got to finish free. I mean, we got to finish down low. This is why I shoot, man, because until you get those top-notch players, it's hard to finish in the paint, man. Montez on a big. I don't like that. All right, so I thought they were going to call the what's the name, but we're good. Let me get that screen from JP. I see you wide open. Timothy White way downtown. Bang! Let's go, boys. One thing I do hate about this game, and I spoke on it last game, is how the bigs don't – people don't really run the floor in this game. I'm going to try it anyway with Montez. Hey! Let's go! I know his three-point shot ain't that high, but for him to knock that down, I'm here for it, though. All right, boys, five-point lead here. Let's be smart. Just want to – oh, keep cutting. Good take. Good finish. Let's go. See, we got to be able to score a little bit more in the paint. One thing I don't want us to do is have to live and die by the three. Yeah, we shoot well from it, but I want to play basketball and be able to get to the basket and get easy, quick shots like we just got. Lock up, Montez. Get through. Good defense for Montez. We gotta get that loose ball. Good trap. Good defense. Yo, we are on their heads right now. Oh, did we really? Wow, the fact that we missed that rebound and then it went off our foot is crazy. And then we give up a wide open layup after that, bro. Locking up. There we go, baby. Ooh. Hell no. He better not hit that. Tough. Dog, that's tough for him to hit that shot from that far. Here we go. Montez switched onto a big. He's going to shoot over him every single time. Montez only being 6'3". 11-11 ball game. We got off to that big start, man, but we're right back to square one. Boom. Oh, kick it out. They're going to really double you? Ah, I see why. We got to hit them shots. One thing we did. Hell no, that's tough. Okay. One thing we did, though, we got Montez on the board early here. He does have points on the board. Oh, he threw that pass away. Turns it over. Oyen back on D. Montez back on D. We do stop ball. Good D. Good block. Loose ball. Montez on it. Keep coming. Come on, Harris. I need you to finish. Let's go. I'm going to shoot that if they don't step up. Oh, okay. JP getting to the basket. Tough pull up. Hey, let's go. All right, guys. Here we go. Kardarius Albright running the one right now. He played a lot of minutes last game when Montez injured. I mean, in foul trouble. Good move there from Wolf. Oh, man. And now Wolf's name is Wolfenbarger, but since his name is so long, it was hard to get his name into the text bubble, into the allotted space. So we had to just change his name to Wolf there. And this time he's going to the line after he already blew an open layup after a good drop step down low. These free throws are tough, dog. I mean, I don't see me hitting one. I could make it easier, but that'd be taking the easy way out. We're just gonna have to deal with the struggles. Oh yeah, we got one. Let's go, bang! And it's from a big man who literally has the worst free throw that we've taken. He has the worst free throw rating of anybody we've taken a free throw with so far in this series, bro. Colt Goodrum on the outside. Wolf leaving his feet too early. So does Stover. Easy layup. This game is pretty back and forth right now. Henderson has 9. He's 4 or 5 from the field. Kardarius, good move. Let's go down to the big man. Boom. Good move. Good. I love it. We got it. Like I said, we got to get those easy baskets a little more consistently. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good D. Ooh, we gave up a dunk there. Okay. So that's what definitely helps us. Boom, good moves there. Yes, sir. That's easy work down low. So when our second team comes in, we're going to be going down low with a lot of our offense there, which is cool with me. You know what I mean? It slows down our tempo a little bit. Goodrum, they're going to let you shoot. They don't believe in your jumper. But we're going right back down to Wolf. Boom. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on. They don't have an answer for it. Get through the screen. We're here. Oh, no. There we go. Close out on all threes. Good D. Tough finish if he hits that. It's stuck on the rim. Oh, man. I wish they had a box out button because they don't. Over on the boards, though. K Wolf, I see you. Get to the basket, Cordarius. Tough finish, baby. Can Francis shoot? I don't think so. That's why they're going to let my man shoot. Boom, going down low to Wolf. He's going to continue to eat down here. Continue to eat down here, baby. Let's go. Look up. Going right back to Wolf again. Can he finish? Tough. Francis on the boards, though. Reset it. Reset it. Cordarius, we're going to take a shot. Hey, let's go. Hot man, hot man. Yeah, that's him. Let's go, baby. Going down low to here to Harris. See what he can do. Can he finish? Because their bigs ain't that good. Oh, my goodness. Let's go, ref. And one. I need a call there, baby. 30 seconds left. Oh, woo. I would have took that, but that's a big. So he can have that. He can have that out there. Make him come to the basket. Good D. Why did not foul? We're holding for the last one? I don't know. We got him trailing. Timothy White. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Let's go, baby. One more stop, dog. One more stop, fellas. One more stop. Get the ball out of his hands. Yes, sir. Good D. Good D. Good D. Good D. He better not hit that. Woo! All right, so Denver is going to go into the half with a little bit of momentum, man, but we hit a three of our own. We're up 9 going into the second half, boys. Loving the way we're playing. You know what I mean? We found out that Wolfenbarger is a force down low when it comes to scoring. He also rebounds and plays defense. This is going to be a good second half. If you guys know anything about EA Sports games, teams turn up in the second half. We're shooting 42% to their 38. We're shooting 45% from 3 to their 67. But our bench is outscoring them 14-2. At the half, Max Wolf leads us in scoring with 9. Timothy White with 6. Montez with 5. Albright with 5. Parker with 5. And Harris with 4. All right, boys. Here we are coming out for the second half, man. You see we're bringing the starters out. But what I'm thinking about doing here, I'm going to take Harris out for Wolf. You know what I'm saying? We're going to bring our boy Wolfenbarger back in here. And then we're going to see what he can do running with the ones. Kadi. Oh, we don't get it back. Where's the big? All right, final guard. There we go, JP. I see you. Working around. That's too much space, sir. Too much space, sir. Stop playing. All right, what are we doing on defense? Somebody's wide open. Tough move. Tough finish. Can we get that animation? That's the one thing about these older games. That spin layup isn't a move. It's an animation. You got to be lucky to get it. Oh, Montez getting to the basket. He gets it blocked, man. Like, we're getting to the rack. That's off. I let that go way too early, fam. So we took Wolf out the game. I don't like that. That's one thing about having auto subs on. Computer going to do what they want. That's some good ball movement here. Oh, I see you. Albright dumping it off. That's not where I want you to dump it off to. Montez, YOLO. Let's go. Come on, baby. I didn't want to pump fake too early. Get out the paint. Let me get a screen here. One more. Ball, good ball movement from the bigs. Let's go. The bigs out here passing well. Down 11. I mean, up 11. I don't know why I want us to be down so bad, bro. Good finish. Oh, good take, rather. He didn't finish it. All right, here we go, boys. 9-point lead here. Montez driving, kicking. Cordarius Albright. Bang! Let's go, baby. Oh, step up, step up. Good D, good D. Where did I foul? I'm loving that my bigs are not fouling down low, bro. Oh, wow, and I'm loving that Montez just getting ripped like he's a little boy. Get through the screen. He can have that. He's not a shooter. He is, though. Bang! Oh, that's off. I'm here for it. Slow it up a little bit. Here we go. Let's be smart. Oh, we get to the basket with Teddy with the left. He blows it. He can't smoke the layup after you get past your man like that, dog. We got to be better than that, fam. Oh, good up and under. He blew it, though. Here we go. Oh, Teddy. I don't know why I just keep going in and forcing it with him because he's working his man so well with the breakdown sessions, man. Little platoon switch here in the second half. You know what I'm saying? Working some things around. Our guy Wolfenbarger still in. Harris is still in with the twos. Trying to go down, work down low with him, and he gets the little fadeaway to go. Oh, good pass. They smoked the layup. Wow, but it doesn't matter when they can get all the rebounds they want. All right, guys, here we are up 9. Under 6 minutes left here in the game. Just be smart here. Slow the offense down. They're slapping the floor thinking they're doing something. Stover getting to the basket. He doesn't get it to go. Really not sure why Stover is in over my guy, Wolf, man. But it's all good. We cannot lose this game late. I could see us losing it late, but hopefully we don't. Oh, that's a good pull. Okay. See you cutting. Oh, he was wide open, too. Cordarius, I need one. Hey, let's go. Good double. Good trap. Good trap. Oh, he finished that still. Oh, no, he blows it. But we just let the guard get his own layups. We love doing that. He's going to the basket and tough. All right, here we go. All right, here we go, boys. We're only up six here. We already know that they're going to make this into a game, bro. Let me get that screen. I don't want one from a guard. I'm good. Let me get one from a big, please. Thank you. There it is. Keep cutting. There we go. Woof. 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 You better than that, baby. Come on now, cuz. Why is Francis still in the game? I didn't really ask for that, but it's all good. JP needs to be in the game, actually. We're going to call a timeout after this possession for them. Oh, okay. We need another timeout. All right, boys, so we're only up four here. It's all good. Come on, Teddy. Do what you do, baby. Yeah. Get him out of here. Get up. Get past half court. There we go. Drive it and kick it. Moving around. We got JP Parker in the game. He's been out of the game for a while, it feels like. Nah, don't force that. Let me get a screen here, though. Oh, did we finish that? Come on, Oyen, let's go. Two-man game between Oyen and JP Parker. JP Parker, man, that kid is a playmaker. He has proven that, man, these first two games. Good D, man. Let's go. Six-point lead. Just got to be smart. We can't let these entry passes get in like that, though. Let's utilize the clock, though, and be smart here. And, you know what I mean, slow the game down. Oh, no. Too much dribbling in his face, and Montez got ripped. Luckily, it went out of bounds. All right, boys, here we go. Utilize this clock. Be smart here. See if you rip me again. Be smart. We need to get a good shot for sure. Boom. Who we got in the game right now? Exactly who I want. Under a minute left on the clock now. There's a good screen. Boom. Drive kick. Need those, JP.
Nope.
Need those. Oh, my goodness. It rimmed out. That was a dagger right there, bro. We're only up four, so no threes, man. That shot right there would have been a dagger. A little bit early on the release, but we got the exact look that we wanted. Montez on a big, and we leave our feet, and they're about to start fouling, and this is how we're going to give up the game. Sometimes I'd rather shoot the ball, you know what I'm saying, to get fouled. I'd rather shoot the ball and take one of my shots, but we're going to do the smart thing and utilize the clock. For some reason, they're not fouling down two. All right, there they go, because the shot clock is finally off. Really not sure what they were thinking. I'm not even sure who to go to here for free throws. Because, I mean, JP is the best shooter on the team. So we'll try to go to our mans right there. But I'm nervous, bro. I'm not even going to hold y'all. I am extremely nervous right now. Let's go all the way backcourt. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to go all the way backcourt, but we go to Teddy Montez instead. I'll be forgetting you got to actually hit the icon of what the player is. Boom. Now you got to utilize speed, JP. He's trying to cut you off. He finally does. 16 seconds left here. Remember, free throws is why we almost lost to Rutgers last game, bro. Like, it's a scary thought. Boom. Just faster than him. Come on. Let's go, JP. I will take that, dog. I will take that. We are up four with 10 seconds left. Okay. Let's go. That's just like getting the two free throws. All right, guys. So even with the 15-minute halves, we're still only 54 to 50. Like, we're still not scoring a ton of points here. Boom. They could have the non-threes. They're really just taking their time here. All right. And they hit that shot, too. But it's all good. Just throw it up. And that's going to be the ball game, guys. We win another nail biter by one on the road. And this Howard Bison team is now 2-0. Amit, their leading scorer, was their leading scorer for them again. But, you know what I'm saying, we were able to shut him down enough to where, you know what I'm saying, his contribution was, you know what I mean, a little bit wasted right there. You see him getting to the basket with that move there. But shout out to Max Wolf off the bench, really being that guy to step up and put us on his back in order to help propel us to this win. So here's the players of the game. For them, it was BB and Mint. He had 18, 5, and 5. For us, it was Steven Harris. He had 8, 5, 1 steal, 1 block. He shot 57% from the field. And Mint shot 70%. Team stats, they out-rebounded us by 11. They had more assists than us. They had more steals than us. Same amount of blocks. They had more fouls. We actually kept our turnovers under 10. That's why I always want to be 10 and under. We only shot 17% from the field to their 67. We shot 36% from 3 to their 43. I mean, 36% from the field to their 43. But we shot 39% from 3. We had 4 offensive rebounds to their 6, and they had 30 defensive rebounds. Player stats, BB Amint, like we said, led them 18-5-5. Bob Clinton had 10-6-2, and then Chris Henderson had 9-10. For us, Cordarius Albright led us in scoring off the bench with 11. Timothy White had 9. 9 points off the bench for Max Wolf. Steven Harris with 8. 8 points for Teddy Montez. I see him actually scoring today. J.P. Parker with only 7 points here in this game, but he was in foul trouble, so that kept him off the floor a little bit. Oyen, 2, 4, and 3, and then Stover had 5 boards off the bench, as well as Goodrum having 2 assists off the bench. All right, guys, so we do it again. We're 2-0 to start off this early season. It's definitely going to get tougher from here, but once we get within our conference play, I think we're going to be running the MEAC conference for some years to come. That's just me personally. I mean, they could have some good ball players there where, you know what I mean, they crack our heads and everything like that. But for the most part, we're playing some of these out-of-conference teams extremely well, and I'm liking the way we're looking. So hopefully you enjoyed this one and you're excited, man. If you did and if you are, stop and smash that like button. Hit me up in the comment section below. Subscribe if you're new. It's your boy Uncle Sam's Reject, rkgames.com. I'm out of here. Peace.
It's 2 a.m. I'm on the west side, rolling with my gang. We've been grinding up this money at your throat just like a necktie, running up some change. We've been stacking up this thriller. 2 a.m. I'm on the west side, rolling with my gang.